Amen. Amen. To all the ministers, elders, evangelists, pastors, deacons, and saints, I greet you all in Jesus' name. Amen. Whew. This is a song embedded in my heart, and you have to forgive me because I am not a singer, but I'm going to sing this one because I love it. Let me get the lyrics because my mind is like all over the place. Okay, the song goes, there is no God like my God. You know the song? There is no God like my God. For he is absolutely awesome, working wonders all the time. There is power in my God. There is power in my God. He is absolutely awesome, working wonders all the time. There is power in my God. It's healing. There is healing. to release it in the name of Jesus. I'm going to have to release it today. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my Savior, Lord God, I thank you and I praise your name. My God, I pray that Sheryll do not be seen, but God, let your Holy Spirit have his way in the name of Jesus. From the pulpit to the door, dear God, I pray that you begin to stir up this atmosphere right now in the name of Jesus. I pray that you begin to touch the broken, the sick, and the wounded, and let the word release be inside their heart as you embedded inside of my heart. Let not me get the glory, but God, all the glory belongs to you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Okay? Amen. When you have it, please say amen. Amen. Woo, glory, glory, glory. God is so good. Oh, this word, I just pray it just bless you like it blessed me. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, glory. So John 8:36 says, if the Son, therefore, shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. My topic today is called release. And that's the word that God had embedded in my heart, release. Oh, mama, this is going to be deep today. My topic is release. Now, when God has given me this word, it blew me away. It completely blew my mind. I said, why? Why release? Why are you telling me about release? When I came to church the other day and Pastor Sheryll, I said, oh, I had no choice but to go in the corner praising. Because I said, you gave him the word that you gave to me, but I still can't speak it. Release. My God. I held on to this word knowing that I wasn't able to speak it before its time. When God told me that his children are caught up in a web, they are caught up in their own ways, they are not listening to the voice of God, and stuck, yes, stuck in the same pattern. He poured his word into my heart to speak to his people today, because today is the day to be released. Jesus Christ is telling us in John 3:28 that he, the Son of God, is here to set us free. Then why else are we stuck in our own ways? Why do we still wear the chains on our hands and feet? Then why are we moving around in dead vines on the tree? It's time to get dirty. It's time to get on the knees and begin to pluck up these dead vines. It is choking the body of Christ. Amen. 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 Jesus is saying that he has made us free. Then why is that you are carrying around some stuff that is causing you to lean over? Excuse me. It's causing you to be angry. That it's causing you to have such a burden upon your shoulders. Have you ever seen a tree when it's so full of fruit, or when a heavy snowstorm comes, they begin to lean over? That's how many of y'all are just leaning over, and y'all carrying the world on your shoulders. Y'all are like the tree full of dead vines, full of dead fruits, full of burdens. Release. 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 Amen. Amen. Your load is too heavy. Release. Your burdens are too heavy. Release. My God, release. Okay, so this doesn't sound like God, does it? God came to save us. He came to set us free. So then why are we carrying heavy burdens? Why are we bent over out of shape? Why are we not standing tall as the tree stands up like it's supposed to? Release. He came to set the captive free. You want to be free? Release. Galatians 5:1 says, stand for, when you stand My children should know that one. We're with Christ. Have made us free. And be not tangled. Entangled, excuse me, again with the yoke of bondage. My God, my God. Once again, God is telling us to be steadfast in the liberty in Christ Jesus. The word liberty means, excuse me, the state of being free within society from oppressive restrictions imposed by authority on one ways of life, behavior, or political views. The word doesn't say, yes, be free in Christ and still carry your heavy burdens. Nor does it say, stay right in the mess that Christ has brought you out of. The word of God is saying, be not entangled. Don't be twisted up together. Mm-mm, don't be twisted up because God set you free. Don't be twisted. Twisted, you know what twisted is? You take two ropes and link them together and you tie it tight so it can't move. You're linking. Now you are stuck. You can't move because the link's been just linking. Now look at you in a web. Heavy, leaned over, bent. You can't stand straight up. Release. The word entangled means to become twisted together with or caught in. I just told you, it links. We're not supposed to be entangled. We are not supposed to be in bondage. We are not supposed to be captive. We are supposed to be free. If you say, yes, Lord, I am going to serve you, then you ought to be free. Why are you entangled? It is time to be untangled. Whoa, Jesus. So many people caught up in the knot. They are caught up in that yoke, a yoke which means a wooden cross piece that is fastened over the necks of two animals and attached to plow or cart that they pull. Now, back in the old days, when a person broke the law, they had a yoke on their neck. So they would sit in a circle for their punishment like this. And the people would see them, knowing that they did a crime. They got a wood over their neck like they are an animal. And they are like stuck. And if they move, they're in trouble. So they have to show their shame. Why are some of us like this? When you say yes to God, you are stuck like this. Come out of your yoke. Come out of the bondage. You have been set free. He's not come to set you free. So why are you stuck like this? Oh my God, you are not an animal. You were not called to pull some things. Oh my God, God begins to speak. Thank you, Jesus. You see. Oh God. Release. 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 Oh, thank you, Jesus. Jesus Christ has set us free. So have you accept being free? Not all of us. Sorry. You have to want to be released from the yoke. You can say, yes, Lord, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. I'm going to run for you. But if you ain't got that yoke out of your system, you have not been released. You still walking around with some stuff. And it's safe. It's time to let it go. Release from your burdens. Release from your old self. Release. You want to be released. You hear me? Release. Christ has set you free. I'm just bringing a word, honey. I'm just bringing a word. Now we're going to go back to 1 Corinthians 5:17, where it says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things are, become new. If the word of God is telling you that we who are in Christ have a new creature and all things are passed away, then why is that many of us are still stuck in our ways? Why is that many of us have not been released from some stuff? Why is that many of us have not been relieved from the sickness out of our body? We just sit here being sick. Why? Why? We've been free. Okay, well, I'm just saying, I'm only giving you what God gave me. Thank you, Jesus. God said, all things become new. And then new, then why are you still angry with your sister and your brothers? You're supposed to be a new creature. You should have been a house of God, mad at one brother on this side, one sister on this side. You won't pass each other thinking somebody got to go, hey, oh, I ain't speaking to her because her shirt is like this. Oh, I ain't speaking to her because this tie don't match your shoe. Oh, he bumped me on the elevator. Oh, he stepped on my toe. Oh, the devil. Oh, the devil's a liar. How you should have been a house of God? Come on, hallelujah. Glory to God, but you're chicken, man, at your sister, brother, on the side.
Check.
Release. Oh, you holding a grudge. Why you still holding?
walking around here with your head to the ground. Why? This is actually why. When you're supposed to be new, your head's supposed to be up like this. Your back pushed back, and you walking like, I got authority. I'm gonna walk in this. This is about me. Right, baby? Mm-hmm. Yeah. I will go shopping. So, you know, we can't just go buy a new dress. We gotta get the new shoes. Yeah. Now, I'm gonna take it far as me. I had to get accessorized. I gotta put it all on because I had to match it up. Because I don't wanna match the old with the new. So, why am I gonna put old wine into a new skin bottle and it's gonna burst on me? Oh, the devil. Oh, the devil. So why are you guys up here in the house of the Lord talking about I got the Holy Ghost, but you got some old dead skin? Your skin is stinking. You know how skin dies? It smells? Ooh, I can smell you. The skin is dead. It is not coming to life because God said what has been old, it is old. And what is new, it's new. So you need to bury the old skin. I'm sorry. Yeah. dig back up. But if you don't be released from that oldness, huh, the newness would never come to full effect. Perfection. There you go. Thank you. Thank you. There you go. I couldn't get out of my head. Thank you very much. But you understand that, right? So you can't. You can't. I'm sorry. There's no way you can walk with something old and dead and sinking and say, God, cover with some newness. Cover with your holiness. Cover with your presence. You can stand here and go hallelujah if you want to. Glory to God. But if you're going to sit here and come to this altar every Sunday, every Wednesday and say, God, I just want to do this and that. God, forgive me. God, but you're going back out to be old and sinking. Oh, you have not been released. You sank. You sank. You sank real bad. I'm sorry. Excuse my words, but that, I'm sorry. Because, not a sweet smell. Sorry. Woo-hoo. Sorry. Let go of that old person. Allow God to work on you. Let God work on you. This is the time that we ought to want to be released from some stuff. No man knows. No man knows the day nor the hour that the Lord Jesus Christ is coming back. Amen. You don't want Jesus to come back and you still have burdens against your brothers and sisters. Amen. You don't want the Lord to come back and you dip it in and out of God's will. Amen. You don't want the Lord to come back and you have lies pouring out your mouth. You don't want the Lord to come back and you shacked up with someone else's husband or wife or somebody who you're not supposed to be with. You don't want the Lord to come back and you over here backbiting about your brother and sister. You don't want the Lord to come back and you got grudges over here and there. You don't want the Lord to come back and your heart is hardened. Oh God, you don't want him to come back and you just sitting in your own mess doing nothing and expecting God to say, come on in. The devil is a liar. Oh, he is a liar. Oh, you better get it together, baby. Oh, you don't want the Lord to come back and you stealing, cheating, backbiting, fornicating. Oh, you don't want the Lord to come back and you commit in adultery. You worship other idols. You don't want the Lord to come back and you are not in your proper place. Or you don't want to come back when yourself is not put together. Oh, you need some new skin, baby. Our walk in Christ should be new. Our talk in Christ should be new. Our life in Christ should be new. Our thinking in Christ should be new. We should be new. Many baptized, many not release themselves to God to make a way for his will. Many have got so used to walking in their old skin that they have set their ways. Many have put up a wall so that nothing new can come in. And now they're walking around with a 10-foot wall on their shoulders because they have been through some trauma in their life. They're too stubborn to allow God to release them for whatever happened to them yesteryear. If I was allowed what happened to me to stay with me to this day, I won't be able to sit here and tell you how good the Lord has been to me. I'm not ashamed. I remember when I was living on Vice Avenue, 174th Street, South Bronx, New York, baby. Before I met this man back here, I was supposed to get married to a man named James. Stop playing. Oh, we had plans. We had preparation. Oh, it was so good. It got so good when he impregnated our sister. And when I got pregnant, he said, hold up. It ain't happening. Because my mother is supposed to be a Christian. What am I doing having a baby out of wedlock? Broke my heart because he didn't want the child. Gave me the money. Go get the abortion done. Got the abortion done. Do you know what happened after the abortion? He said, he didn't say, hey, baby, is everything okay? Is everything fine? He said, is it done? I mean, come on. I'm dealing with life issues of being molested. I'm dealing with life issues of being raped. I'm dealing with life issues of being rejected. So much things was going on in my life. Oh, I wasn't saved. I don't know about Jesus. Oh, God, I don't know him. I don't know nothing about him. Never experienced him. Don't know where he coming or where he was going. I had no clue. I saw the church folks come around the corner. I used to watch them as they put their cigarettes on the store. So, you want me to go up in there? I can do the same thing you're doing up in here. I'll smoke my Newports right here by myself, baby. Thank you very much. But that's what he said to me. He said to me, is it done? And so I'm going to a basketball, a football game, sorry, at that time, and left me there. I was confused. I was hurt. I was bitter. I was torn. Somebody ripped something out of me because
me. He has released me from attitude. Oh, don't look at these battle scars and let it fool you. Because I was a rough neck and I was not a lady about it. I was not a lady. Not at all. I'll fight your mama, your brother, your sister, your father, your grandmother. I'll come to your house and fight everybody in your house. And I wouldn't have killed who came to the door. Oh, Satan was trying to kill me. But God, he may have been in the world, but in the world he was like, you know what, Sheryll? This, you know, Jesus did this, and me like a kid, like, really? Why? He don't see me. Why? Why would he do that? And it got my wheels turning. Well, let me go find out for Jesus for myself. And I went in. I said, the lady, I remember her name was Lady Amadea. She said, do you want to join the church? I was like, no. Attitude, yes, I did. And I was like, no. And when she asked me to join the church, I look crazy in here. Speaking of some tongues, I don't understand what y'all saying. Dance around the church. What's wrong with these people? That's how I was. I'm sorry. That's how I was. And then I didn't come back for like 3 weeks to show my sister-in-law invited me again. And oh, I thank God that set me up. Because when I walked in the second time, I had tears coming down like somebody beat me up in the church. And I said, yes, Jesus. I used to feel like I was convicted. Like, oh God, you delivered me. Here goes the reminder. What I did semi-years ago. Why? Why is it here? Oh, the devil. But God said, 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I'm going to say again. If you have an ought against your brothers and sisters, how can you go to God and say, forgive me? Today's a new day. The night has not fallen away yet. Today's a new day. Release. He will begin to release us from our sins, and he will begin to set us free. I got on my knees, and I thank the good Lord for setting me free. Time to run to God and ask God to begin to release some stuff in your life. Pull on the name of the Lord, no matter who is looking at you. For now is the time for us to be set free. Do you want to stand in the liberty of Christ? A quick reminder in Jesus Christ, who walked not after the flesh. Oh, I'm sorry. Romans 8:1. There is therefore now no condemnation to those which are in Jesus Christ, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. See, now I gotta stop you. The flesh is a dangerous thing. This skin that we got on our body is dangerous. I told you, start shedding. Get into that spot, get a stick, and start shedding the skin off. Begin to shed, because if you keep that skin on, you're going to die in it. It's becoming too tight. You know, when the animals get tight, they start busting at the seam. You have been busted for years. Come out of it, come out your own skin, and begin to work in God. Begin to move in God. Begin to be released in God. For God is calling a holy nation. He is not calling for you to sit here and be cute about it. He said, get down and get dirty and start working for me. You can't sit get released. They get released. They're going to have to get released, Gaynor. Because if they don't get released, they're going to die in their old skin. They won't get caught up. They won't get caught up to the gates of heaven. They will go down into the hell gate and say, God, why? Because you would not be released from your sins, from your transgressions. God said, be released. I need to have them all in order for me to be refreshed in the Lord. Galatians 5:22-20 says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. Who not all? Release. Nobody got it. Release.